Hey guys, welcome to Manoeuvre. I'm Advocate Nisha Lotia, and in my today's video, we will discuss about the English section for IPM and BBA programs 2022. So let me start with an interesting question, guys. That do you really want to be a topper? If yes, then stay tuned with me right up till the end, and I assure you that I will not let you down, and I will really spill the beans of the topper strategy. But before getting started, let me make you aware that the competition this year is too high, as almost 30,000 students has registered for IIM Indore this year, and we see the number rising each year. So it's needless to say that you need to strive really hard to achieve your desired score, and for this Manoeuvre is offering you the entire program, which will include your live classes, guys, ebooks, which will also include the doubt sessions, the recorded video, the topic test, mock test, guys, which is the heart and soul of any of the entrance exam, and the analysis of the mock, which will really place you high among the competition. Then WhatsApp group, which is really helpful in your quick solving the questions and when you're demotivated and stuff like that. Then 10,000 plus questions, and the most important among all of them is the mentorship. Our mentors, they appear paper every year, guys, so we have the experienced mentors who know what type of questions and be really covered by the examiners and how you should deal with it. So for any of the queries or for registering yourself, you can contact us on 8828581454, or you can visit us on into our website, guys. So this is the program, the entire program. If you have any ifs and buts, if you have any doubt regarding the competition level, or if you're petrified, then do not waste the time. Come with a positive attitude, and we are sure you will go back with a double positive attitude, guys. So as I told you earlier, that what is the difference between a topper, guys, and what is the difference between a regular student? When the same faculty, same mentors, same books, both of the students refer, then why do one of the students scores really high and what about the others? Okay, so I'm gonna tell you what is their approach, what is a topper's approach when it comes to the exams, guys. It is nothing that they have extra mind, or they have extra solving capacity. No, it's nothing like that, but the approach matters. This is the 100% guarantee I say. If you will follow this approach, you will see yourself one of the best positions. Okay, the first over here I've mentioned is first time right. The concept clarity, guys, the concept clarity. Remember, it is just an MCQ. You do not need to reproduce the entire answers. The concept clarity has to be 100%. If any of the concept, if you're studying, for example, if you're studying reading comprehension, but you're not getting through, what type of questions they're going to pose. So even if you know what is reading comprehension, it will not give you the desired results, right? So 100% concept clarity, and that too with the approach of entrance exam, is the topmost thing that you need to do. Okay, next is stick to your own notes. Do not get confused. Okay, do not get confused. Trust the mentor whom you are following. There are 100 of the people who will come and say, ki yaar, I have done this and I have done that. But do not do that. Stick to your own notes. First of all, have a complete knowledge about the syllabus, and then stick to your own notes. Make such notes which will, be very helpful and handy during your end time preparations. Okay, now what is this? A sight before night. What is this? A sight before night. For example, if you're going through a very, very new concept, okay, that might be a bit tough, bit tricky for the first time readers, okay, but if it is the concept, then you have left it over there. Do not go to bed before referring the same thing that very particular night itself. Make that sure that you are you have 100% clarity on the topics. So a sight before the night is very, very important when it comes to the things that you really find difficult. Dekho, jitna difficult concept hai na, aapko usse bhagna nahi hai. You have to really tackle it out. Am I clear about it? Because we cannot take any chances, because it is an MCQ. It is, you do not have to write the entire paragraph or entire passages. Jahan pe, thoda bahut chal jata hai. MCQ needs a perfection, guys. MCQ looks to be easy but difficult when you actually solve it. Okay. Now this is very interesting. That is, close your book. Okay. Now, I have seen students, you know, they tell me, ma'am, I study for 14 hours, I study for 15 hours. But is this really required? Is this input is really required? No. If you make a particular timetable, then you should have a time to close your book, you know, refresh yourself and revitalize yourself for the next day also. You can't be, you know, sticking to the book the entire day. The productivity will be really not up to the mark, guys. Very, very important is for you to take that short breaks. But when are you eligible for those short breaks? When you have really done a qualitative study. I'm not talking about the quantitative study. I'm talking about the qualitative study. Be true to yourself, guys. Be true. The first and the utmost thing, because your parents, they don't know what is an entrance exam. They don't know what you're studying. You have to be true to yourself. Okay. So close your book. This is the ideal thing a topper does. He has his own timetable. He has his own timetable. And there is a mentioning about close your books, whereby, you know, once again, when you're going to open your book, you're going to be as fresh and you can grasp maximum of the things. Next is, you know, enjoy your studies. I think that people slug, you know, they are literally sluggish in their nature, correct? They are, you know, doing it forcibly. They are doing the studies forcibly. Aray yaar, ye topic hai, ye nahi aa raha hai. Aray yaar, grammar hai, wo nahi padhna hai. Puzzle to kitna boring hai. No, guys, it is a fact that you have those types of questions. You cannot run away from that. You have to keep your, you know, goal. For example, if you want to be, you know, a lawyer, or you want to be an, you know, management studies, you want to do your MBA, keep yourself, you know, dress yourself accordingly to that attire and post your own pic, you know, onto the pin-up board, and please feel motivated by that. Okay, so enjoy your studies, because it is your bright future is waiting for you. But the basis is only this entrance exam, guys. Only this entrance exam is the basis of it, so you can't, you know, run away from it. So these five things, and in addition to the entrance exam approach, will surely, you know, place you in a much higher position than you are might be receiving your marks till now. Okay, the next, when it comes to English section particularly, I must say reading is a must, guys. Whoever is a good reader will be a leader in the entrance exam, because, you know, the reading comprehensions, the paragraph jumbles, the close test, these are the things which will require lots and lots of reading. Not only reading plus understanding at the same time, guys. We don't have time to reread the concepts there. Okay, so reading a newspaper should be a very good habit for you guys, and which will help you a lot. Okay, focus more on grammar. People, whenever it comes to grammar, people are so confused ki kab has use karna hai, kab have use karna hai, what is a pronoun, what is an adverb, what is a golden rule of an adverb, what is singular, what is plural. Guys, learn from a mentor who herself or himself is clear about it, and I'll tell you, in our classes, in 2 to 3 lectures, we make them study grammar, and then there is no confusion about it. Okay, any new type of question, it being an entrance exam, can be framed from grammar. Grammar already carries a weightage of 5 to 6 marks, and any new type of question, you know, can increase that weightage. So this 5 to 6 marks, according to me, is comparatively very, very easy, as you know, compared to your reading comprehension. Okay, next in the line is to speak in English. See, don't run away from the language, guys. Don't run away from the language. We find, you know, English movies to be so very interesting as compared to the Hindi movies. But why do we not watch the number of movies in English, how much we watch in, you know, Hindi, is because we are not comfortable with the language. Guys, don't run away with the problem. Face it and solve it, and things will fall in the correct place. Share your, you know, this program that you want to, you know, be ace your English. So you're going to, you know, tell your family members that I'm going to use the language English, no matter whatever language they answer you back, but you stick to your English. Okay, share this with your friends also, that let's, you know, speak in English, make a group, you know, it's gonna interesting way where every day you will learn some good vocabularies, and moreover, you will, you know, even polish your grammar, guys. very very important part over here is the prefix and suffix. If at all you are having some new words in your exams, which, you know, English being such a vast language, there are chances that you will encounter some words which you are hearing for the first time, but with the help of prefix and suffix, many a times you can crack that word. What does it mean? Whether it is a positive word, whether it is a negative word, what it is, everything can be, you know, cracked with the help of prefix and suffix. So always, you know, just a decrease. So DE, so DE is always diminishing level, correct? So aise hota hai, omnipresent. Omni means, you know, everywhere. So there are some prefix, suffix, some root words which will, you know, really strengthen your vocabs, guys. Like, and the last and most of the least of over here is appear as many as mocks possible and analysis of the mocks. Guys, we here at Maneuver provide the mocks which are the replicas of your exams, guys. They are the replicas. You know, everything, how much a topper took time, how much you are taking time, what is the accuracy, what type of questions you're going to follow, what sections, you know, you need to do first, what is your strength, what is your weakness, everything can be done once you appear for the mocks, guys. We have students who have started registering, you know, for 2023 programs, guys. So if you are planning to appear in 2022, then I must say you are already late, guys. So if you have not started your preparation, do start your preparation, okay? And Maneuver is offering the entire package, guys, okay? We have the mock test, which is really, really helpful and beneficial. So I am sure that, you know, if with the toppers approach and the entrance exam approach, if you're gonna merge these two points and, you know, then revise your timetable or revise your approach towards the studies, you're gonna be a topper. And this is, I can guarantee it, okay? I can guarantee, guys, okay? Now, the first stepping stone, okay, guys, the first stepping stone about any entrance exam is nothing but the syllabus. Jitna important hai for you to know what you have to study, correct, utna hi important hai for you to know what you don't have to study. Why? Because time is the essence over here. Time is the essence, okay? So aapko kya karna hai aur kya nahi karna hai, that should be really very much clear in your mind, okay? So just, you know, pause the video and jot down these topics. These are the utmost important topics when it comes to English section for IPMET and BBA programs, guys, whether it is NPET, CRIS, CUT, okay, guys? So please be careful about this, okay? Reading comprehension, I don't need to explain what is reading comprehension, but you must always understand ki what types of questions you're gonna, you know, follow when it is a reading comprehension. What types of questions they ask? Questions like, you know, what which statement will strengthen the argument of the author, or which is a false statement. So kind of they are direct ones, but then the MCQ type is really difficult if you don't understand how to solve it. So reading comprehension, as I told you, requires lots and lots of reading practice, which only then you can ace through the subject, guys. Everyday newspaper, the editorial cut, the topics what they cover is very very important. Now I have got some students who tell me, ma'am, I read a novel about this and about that and all, but that novel will only give you an idea about a particular subject. So you are, and you know, you will encounter only particular types of vocabulary, but we have to ace it because we don't know what type of passage you're going to encounter on your D-Day. So newspapers are the best things that you need to refer. Okay, next in the line is, guys, your error detection. Error detection is again your grammar based question, as I told you, okay? It is a sentence which is fragmented into five parts and you need to find the error. Now the cherry on the cake over here is that you don't have to rectify the error, you only have to find the error. And you know, our mentors provide such, you know, great techniques and strategy whereby grammar also becomes easy and you will actually know what types of questions you can expect in your error detection. Sentence improvement, again, which is grammar based, which is a higher version of, you know, error detection, which there is a highlighted part and you need to improvise that statement, okay? So sentence improvement, again, on a grammar part. Paragraph jumble, very very interesting, and most of the students find it difficult or confusing. Why? Because there are 4 to 5 sentences mentioned which can be lengthy also, guys, and they are jumbled up. Internally they are all okay, but they are jumbled up. You need to, you know, sequence them in a proper order to form a coherent paragraph, guys. Coherent means a meaningful paragraph. So you don't have time to read the entire thing and then analyze it and do. So we give you certain keywords, okay? We give you certain mandatory pairs, which if you know will help you in a long way to solve the paragraph jumbles. So without a good mentorship, it will be really difficult to solve question like paragraph jumbles, because usme bhi kafi type ke variations hote hain. Jaise agar they are providing you opening and closing, then you have to just arrange the central theme. Sometimes they don't give you the options, they just ask you which is the first statement after, you know, sequencing it up and all, rearrangement and all. So all types of questions, we give you a lot of practice. Next is the paragraph completion, which is again similar to paragraph jumbles, but a different variation of a type of the question, guys. Close test is again, you will find close test to be a normal fill up, but it is not a normal fill up, guys. Let me warn you, the options A, B, C and D for the MCQ, all the options will be so close to each other. For example, devaluation, या demoralization, या फिर added, increased, है ना, arisen, these types of words which are really close to each other, but you need to find the perfect word which is, you know, which will fit in that particular blank and will give you a meaningful sentence, guys. Next is the idioms and phrases, okay, synonyms, antonyms, confusing words, okay, all these things require the perfect material. See, there are lots of idioms, there are lots of, you know, synonyms, antonyms, but what is required for the, you know, entrance exam, that can be, you know, only guided by a, you know, mentor who is appearing the paper, okay. One word substitution, okay, we have the material which will give you the exact idea ki entrance level pe kya hota hai. Phrasal replacement, again, you know, which of the, like, say, settle down, so iron down, okay. All these types of words will really, you know, matter a lot. These are the petty things, you know, 3 to 4 marks in your examinations. But I'll tell you, these 3 to 4 marks plays a very, very important role. Okay, and for this, the correct material is very, very important, guys. So IPMET covers all these topics except the one word substitution and the phrasal verb. And BBA programs does not have the paragraph completion. So all this awareness you should have before you enter your examination hall, guys, or before, let me make it clear, before even you start your preparation, because syllabus awareness is one of the most crucial thing to start your preparation, guys. So you can follow us on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, guys, and join our Telegram channel, where we will post you with, you know, any of the further notifications and, you know, stuff like that, which will really keep you boosting for your, you know, boosting and will keep you motivated also. Do share this link with your friends and family who is planning to appear, so can they also can, you know, gear up with the live classes, or they also can gear up with the preparation strategy. So see you soon in my live class, and check the link in the description if you plan to, you know, join Manuver. Thanks and all the best for your preparation.